We know you all have a lot of questions about this variant, the differences and what it means for you and your family, and of course the possibility about even more boosters.
And that's why we took your questions to two doctors in Northern California. Dr. Vanessa Walker provides specialized care for complex, critically ill patients at Pulmonary Medicine Associates. And then Dr. Dean Blumberg is the chief of pediatric infectious diseases at UC Davis Children's Hospital. So our first question, there are tons of COVID-19 variants out there. What makes this variant such a concern?
We've all heard about different mutations that have occurred. And I think some of us, including me, you hear about a new variant and you think, oh yeah, there's always a new variant, but is it significant? And I think that's what's different about today is we're hearing that this new variant is significant. It is a variant of concern.
There are so many variants, which is to be expected. The way that this virus replicates, how quickly it spreads across, you know, it spread across the world, it's had plenty of opportunities to make variations. And so this isn't surprising that we've seen this. In fact, we've all kind of been expecting this to happen.
It appears to be more contagious and it might escape vaccine-induced immunity. So there are significant concerns about this variant.
I think some good news on the horizon is the fact that we do have medications coming out that can treat COVID once you get it.
We also asked our doctors, how do they plan on answering their patients' questions about this new variant?
I mean, I think most people aren't going to be focused on all the, scientific little tidbits that are going into this, right? Which type of amino acid is replacing which? That's not what they care about. They care about, how is this going to affect me? How is this going to affect my family?
I think it causes some anxiety, but it's a wait and see situation. So we'll have to see how fast this spreads. Is it really that transmissible in different circumstances?
Right now, it's definitely not circulating in this country. We have not seen any evidence that it's circulating in this country. But if it does, and eventually I guarantee you it will, we have the tools to fight this.
We're also concerned, is it more serious? Does it result in more serious disease that increases the rate of hospitalization or even death compared to previous strains? So there's a lot of questions and not many answers yet. And so that to me is the important thing, is to wait for the actual data to see how concerned we need to be about it.
And finally, a question many of us had even before this latest variant. With the flu shot, many get flu shots every year. With these variants, will we have to get boosters every 6 months?
It's going to take time for us to see how this plays out as to whether or not we need boosters more frequently than we would typically expect, like we do with influenza. The reason why it might be more likely that that would be the case is because with influenza, we get a break, right? It goes around, it's seasonal. COVID isn't seasonal, it's always there. And it's always going to be there, unfortunately.
We're just at the beginning of understanding how immunization protects against COVID. We know that it protects very well, but we're still not sure if the optimal initial series is a 2 or 3 dose series, how long that's going to last, whether we're gonna need boosters every year or every 10 years, or whether the boosters will need to be changed and to adapt to the current circulating strains. These are all questions, and we just don't have answers yet.